video, I'll be showing you a typical day at my school in Beijing, China. Now I'm at my dorm. It's Wednesday evening, and it's about 10:30 p.m. But let me show you around my dorm.
So let me take you around our dorm room. This is the entrance from which we come in. This is the corridor outside. Come in to the left. This is the showering area. Pretty spacious. As you see, this is a dorm room for four. We have two bunker beds. These are racks for us to hang our clothes and towels. And we also have shelves up here to put our stuff. The one with the teddy bear is mine. That's my teddy bear. These two are mine too. Books, comb, and some random hairbands. Our room is on the fifth floor, so we have a pretty nice view of the soccer field down there. To your left side, you can see a building. That's the International Department's building, and that's where I have the majority of my classes.
So I'll just be rambling a bit about what the schedule of a typical day be like over here at my school. So we have 8 classes every day. 4 in the morning and 4 in the afternoon, and classes start at 8 in the morning and end at 4:10 in the afternoon. And then after that pencil study, we can come back to the dorms, and I think lights out is at 10:20, but we almost never strictly follow that rule because we're seniors. Yeah, so I'll see you in the morning. See you then.
You didn't realize this was... Hey!
You are blocked.
The larger
the is, the more room the ghost has.
Oh, you're Chinese, I've learned Chinese restaurants. Chinese, but also like Latin sentences, so like well, Thai la la. So the dynamic of Beijing is Beijing. England has this very particular thing where each city has a formal dynamic. So it's not from Liverpool, it's called Liverpool. But then they also have these other dynamics in each city that normally has nothing to do with the actual name of the city itself. So someone from Liverpool is called a Scouser, someone from Newcastle is called a Geordie, and they all have, and that's how you identify. So people never say to you, are you a Liverpool? They just say, are you a Scouser?
Right, thank you very much. I'll see you tomorrow.
So what are structural isomers? Let's just do a quick review then. What is a structural isomer?
They have same formula, but they have different structures.
Yeah, exactly. The molecular formula is identical, but the orientation and the arrangement of the atoms, that's going to be different. So that's something to look out for.
Hey, now we're at the third period in the afternoon. And I have POK class. But since we're already in grade 12 and we've already finished our POK essay and exhibition, we're basically having self-study. So I asked Marie to come and take a walk around the campus.
See, these are all the flowers that are next to it. This is the arts building. That's the gym. And now we're nearing the library. I love this building because it has a lot of glass panels there. This is another school within our school campus for some reason. And I think these are elementary school kids having PE class. This is our dorm from behind our dorm building. This is the high school building for our national department. And we're now taking you to the wooden house. It used to be dilapidated, but I think they renovated it, and now there's a nice small space in here. Yeah. And a place where we can borrow books, I think.
You'll see.
I think. Not a lot of interesting books that I would like to read though.
There's a Game of Thrones one.
Yes, but it's taken now, so it's not there. So now there's no more interesting
you
books.
You took it.
I took it. We took it.
You took it.
And now, this is the supermarket at our school.
So we came out of the supermarket because neither of us are hungry, so we don't want to buy anything.
our free period is almost over, and now we're heading back to our international department's building for our...
So sad! So sad! Isn't it sad? Isn't it sad?
It's very sad.
Hi class, I'm John Gough, the creator of the Love Lab. And at the Love Lab, we can predict divorce with over 90% accuracy.
Hey, question.
Are you talking about the study they did in 1994? Well, it's a little old, but our research has been replicated by Ronald Kruger and Julia Babcock. Cool. But, like, weren't all of your participants from Indiana or something? Like, all your participants are American.
I am narrating, you're gonna hear all of this.
Okay.
So basically down the hall over there, the sunlight is usually very good, and but lots of people. And I'm on this side, who is really, really bad. So she wants it. And there she wants a teacher. Who is that? There's a kid there. Mighty easy. I'll try again. I want food.
My second favorite, Liu sister. Goodbye. See, that's my joke, right? Good luck wherever you end up.
Stop posing for the camera.
Stop posing. It's just me being me. This is natural. This exactly just defies our relationship. This is it. She's nagging at me.